Welcome back to my channel and to today's video. For those who are new here, my name is Julia Tireri. I focus on motivational, lifestyle and travel content. I love to learn, teach and celebrate life, and that's what we do here on the Juliet Method. So today, Motivational Monday, I'd like to talk about personalities and specifically about a personality test I took. I learned of this personality test from Over 25. They're a group of amazing ladies who have a channel, a YouTube channel. They're from Kenya. So I saw they took this test and I was also wishing that I was with someone while taking this test, because it would have been better like to see what her outcome is. Like I was telling my bestie Marcy, I wish we were together so that she would have taken, so I could see her outcome, she could see my outcome, and in as much as we may agree or disagree with it, we could also play off each other in that sense and say, oh yeah, this is right, this is wrong. But I'm by myself, which is still okay, and I took this test. It took me I don't know if it took me more than 10 minutes. It's a very interesting test. I'll link it for you down below so that you can also take it for yourself if you feel like you're interested in doing so. So I decided, let me share with you the results of my test. You can get to know me better, and maybe also it will intrigue your interest in trying to in taking the test. For me, it is not only fun, a good pastime right now that we are mainly at home, but as well it is important as well in getting to know or understand yourself a bit more better, getting to understand how you, why you do the things you do, or how you do them. And also it can help you gain more insight into yourself, into your relationships with others, and even know where to improve, because there's also a place where it gives you your strengths and your weaknesses and so on and so forth. So let me just give you a try as much as possible to give you a quick overview of the results I got when I took the test. And again, before I even give you this, it is important to be as honest as possible, as hard as it may be, while answering the questions, because that's how you can get an accurate or nearby, a very close to accurate assessment of yourself. So my test results, I got the advocate type, and then in brackets it says NFJT. I have to read this through because there's so much, but I'll try to summarize it. My traits, I got 78% introverted, 56% intuitive, 96% feeling, 76% judging, and 78% turbulent. My role is diplomat. My strategy is constant improvement. When you read more, you'll understand more what I'm talking about, the traits, the role, and the strategies. Okay? So before I continue, one fun thing I learned from this is it also gives you like other people, well-known people who have similar personality traits to you. And I have to say, I was so happy about the people I was linked to, or rather who share my the same personality traits according to this test. Okay, according to this test, but it was still so amazing and so amusing. Nelson Mandela, but do I say Martin Luther King, but do I say Mother Teresa, Marie Kondo. Those who don't know Marie Kondo, Marie Kondo has a show on Netflix. She's a very teaches people how to organize and how to be functional minimalist, if I can put it in that way. But yeah, I kind of relate to her. Those who know me know my A-type personality, especially when it comes to organizing and placing things and such. I usually joke I have mild OCD tendencies. So yeah, and then there is Nicole Kidman, there's Lady Gaga, and Morgan Freeman. I love Morgan Freeman. So those are some of the people who I was linked to. So there's also another sub breakdown where it says like my when it comes to mind, I am 78% introverted, 22% extroverted. When it comes to energy, I am 56% intuitive. What I was trying to read for you, but again, when you do the test, you'll get to understand it more. I'm 50. When it comes to energy, mental energy, I'm 56% intuitive, 44% observant. So most of it is intuitive. When it comes to making decisions and coping with my emotions, I'm 96% feeling, 4% thinking. I so totally agree with all these things, by the way. When it comes to my approach in work, planning and decision making, I'm 76% judging, 24% prospecting, meaning I deal with what I can see head on. Basically that's how I understood it. Anyway, identity, showing how confident we are in our abilities and decisions, I'm 78% turbulent and 22% assertive, meaning I think I tend to not be so confident in myself most of the time. Okay, so and a brief introduction. I'm just going to try and get as little as possible out of everything, so that again I say this is basically something you can do, but also you can get to know me better as we go along and as we grow this channel. So the advocate personality type is very rare, making up less than 1% of the population, but they nonetheless leave their mark on the world. Advocates have an inborn sense of idealism and morality, but what sets them apart is that they are not idle dreamers. These individuals are capable of taking concrete steps to realize their goals and make lasting positive impact. I truly love that. So I'll go directly into strengths and weaknesses. They've also explained, but I'll just give you a quick overview. Creative, I agree with that. Insightful, inspiring and convincing. Decisive, determined and passionate. Altruistic. Advocates' weaknesses: sensitive, extremely private, perfectionist, always need to have a cause, can burn out easily. I totally agree. Then there's also a part where they try to explain how advocates are when it comes to romantic relationships. A brief overview again. When it comes to romantic relationships, advocates take the process of finding a partner seriously, not once for casual encounters. People with the advocate personality type instead look for depth and meaning in their relationships. So it goes on and on and to explain. And then there's a quote. One of the things advocates find most important is establishing genuine, deep connections with the people they care about, and I totally agree that as far as I'm concerned. Then when it comes to friendships, there is a running theme with advocates, and that is the desire for authenticity and sincerity in their activities, their romantic relationships and their friendships. People with the advocate personality type are unlikely to go for friendships of circumstance. They avoid situations like workplace social circles or chatting up their local baristas, where the only thing they really have in common is regular contact. So I tend to somewhat agree with it. Again, having the introverted personality, I rarely get to like go out, and the few people that are really close to me, I really keep close to me. So I agree with this. In friendship, it's as though advocates are searching for a soulmate, someone who shares every facet of their passions and imaginations. The downside I can see to this, and I've seen in myself, is that when someone breaks that bond, more often than not, it shatters. It is very hard for me to like regain trust again once it's like broken or shattered. So I think that's the one downside I can pick to having my personality types when it comes to friendships and relationships. Then parenthood. I'm not a parent yet, but this is it's quite interesting to know. As parents, advocates will tend to look at their relationships with their children as opportunities to learn and grow with someone they care about. They will also work to achieve another important goal, raising their children to be independent and all-round good people. I love that so much. Advocate parents want to raise children who are ethical, creative, and kind. Ethical, creative, and kind. I just love that so much. That has just touched me deep in my soul, and I pray to be such a parent. Career paths. Advocates are likely to find the most corporate career paths are not designed for them. However, people with this personality are able to find work that suits them in just about any field, which also makes quite a lot of sense, because what I was trained for in what I trained for in university is not what I'm practicing right now, and what I'm practicing right now and what I do like on this channel is totally different. So I get that assessment, and I believe I do everything that I do pretty well, so that makes a lot of sense. For advocates, money and employee of the month simply won't cut it compared to living their values and principles. Okay, workplace habits. Advocates have pretty tall demands when it comes to a satisfying work environment. Not only do those with this personality type need to be able to express their creativity and insight, they also need to know that what they are doing has meaning. That just speaks to me, kabisa. And it goes down to break down advocate colleagues, advocate managers, advocate subordinates, and gives just the breakdown for each and everything. So if you actually do the quiz, let me know what you think about it. Do you think it makes sense when it comes to you? And those who get the advocate diplomat personality, let me know, how do you agree with what it says? Because personally, what I have read in relation to my life in the areas that it applies actually makes so much sense. So in conclusion, few personality types are as passionate and mysterious as advocates. As someone with this personality type, your imagination and empathy make you someone who cherishes the integrity and deeply held principles. Unlike many other idealistic types, however, you are also capable of turning those ideals into plans and executing them. So I just so love that. I just love that breakdown. So basically, we tend to have very big ideologies and ideas of what we want to do and the purpose we might have and where we want to go with it. And most of the time that can seem wishy-washy and maybe like fantasy and such, but we also have that capability to carry it forward into fruition. So I love that aspect. I really love that. So basically, that was a rough idea of what is involved in the personality 16. It's actually called 16 personality test, which again I have linked in my description box. Please check it out, and then you can see if you. I actually decided to do it because I thought it was, yes, it can motivate you, but it's also a fun thing to do. This time we have the time, you can sit down and do it, and have enough time to read through it and see where you can adjust yourself, develop yourself, grow yourself, how you can also how you can maybe develop and grow your relationships in relation to the results you get from the test. A fun fact, this is the third time I'm trying to do this video. The first time, apparently, I wasn't even filming. I don't know why. The second time is just showing my neck up. So today, I wanted to do it, but then it's raining. So now I'm indoors. I hope you don't mind. But I think it's still good to have a change. Outside, inside. And I'm grateful for the rain because it cools down the temperatures a little bit here. So I hope you take the test. I hope you appreciate what it gives you, the insight it gives you to yourself and how you behave and how you act and how you interact with others. Let me know, comment down below if you take the test. What was your result, personality type? Did you agree with what the test was saying? Amma, you had some discrepancies here and there. Hopefully one other time I can retake it when I'm with one of my friends or a couple of my friends, and then we can play off each other. But for today, I was by myself, and hey, we have to make best of what we have in the situation we're in at that time. So anyway, darlings, thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you learned something new about me, and I hope I can learn something new about you. If you liked the video and you liked my other videos, or you watch another one, or if you haven't watched another one and if you like it, like, share, subscribe. Let's grow this amazing, positive, beautiful community of ours. Spread love and light, guys. Spread love and light, and stay healthy. Toodles!